Hey guys, it's another Beaver Fever Juice Review. I'm Gage.
I'm Adam.
And today we're talking about the last two juices from the Marslow line. I'm vaping on Safety, which is a lemon cake with vanilla icing.
I've got Psychological, which is a grape and berry mixture. Both very good juices.
Both of which are awesome. I'm really liking this lemon. I haven't had a lot of lemon juices, but this is... I really
like that one too, actually. It's really good.
You know who wasn't vaping on Safety? Stay tuned and find out.
So before we talk about this, these two juices from Maslow, we're going to talk about some hardware. I've got my Tesla Invader 3, and I decided to bring a tank today. I brought my Griffin 25. I got some giant dual-fuse Claptons in there. Came out to 0.35 or something like that.
Nice.
It vapes nice.
Right on. I've got my K-Box 200, Triton V1 on top, Clapton coil inside, hitting at 50 watts. It's going good. Both of us, I'm pretty sure, are repping some regulated mods.
Well, semi-regulated.
Well, semi-regulated, regulated. There's something in there to tell it to stop doing stuff before it's going to blow us up.
So we're going to talk about this article just
about somebody who blew themselves up.
I'm just going to start by saying I don't think mech mod should be available to people.
It's pretty reasonable.
If you need to be an expert in something to safely use it, I mean, is there really a point?
Probably not. Like, well, I mean, if you're an expert, then yeah.
Yeah, but I mean, like, that being said, I have no idea how dynamite works.
Exactly.
I can't go buy dynamite. The short of this is that I've had a lot of people coming to me, and Adam's had people coming to him, and people in the community.
And Brianna Jord's fiance had her mom go to her, and just
people who are generally concerned that vaporizers are going
to blow up.
I'm not going to really get into the details of it, but when you hear about a vaporizer exploding or blowing up or batteries venting, 99% of the time, it's human error. And I don't mean like they did something dumb. I mean like they did something and didn't know. They didn't fully understand what they were doing and did it. The case of the most recent one where the guy had his face blew up with a vape, unregulated, mech mod with a dripper that had way too short of a pin, with a 0.06 build in it. Like, that's ridiculous. I personally wouldn't vape a 0.6 build on a regulated device. That's just me.
To put this into easier words, unregulated, what I mean is like there's computer chips in ours. There's computer chips in ours that say when it
Even
shouldn't
the Tesla.
Fire.
The Tesla has a chip in
exactly.
it.
Exactly. It just tells the device not to fire, not to make a connection because it's bad. As for like the 0.06 ohms, that is a lot of power.
That's a lot of
really
resistance.
Fast.
That's a lot of resistance. Like,
it's no resistance. That is the 0.06.
Yeah, it's almost none.
Yeah. So that's full power coming from a battery. Actually, more than full power because it'd be asking for.
Yeah,
I think you made it out to like 60 amps.
The math is coming out to something like 60 amps on a single 18650,
which is supposed to push 20. So that's triple the power coming out of a battery. Your battery is going to then overheat. I believe the
overheating batteries can lead to ruptures. They can lead to venting. Venting is like when there's a chemical reaction inside the battery and the a gas is made, which is why mods have holes in them somewhere.
Yeah,
the K-Box is full of holes actually.
Nice and airy.
And that's so that they vent. And part of that is that when a battery vents and an insane amount of power is compressed into a very small area. So most mech mods, for one reason or another, don't have venting. So now you have a tube that's this big full of a gas that eventually needs to go
somewhere.
Like, there are two ways for vapes to go wrong. One of them is people building and they don't quite understand what they're doing. And the other way is battery venting. Generally, if your mod has venting holes, a battery venting is scary as fuck, like any way you cut it.
But the
holes let the pressure release,
which in turn stops it from blowing up.
Yeah.
So what happened to this guy is he had too little of ohms, like he had no resistance pushing out triple the power of his battery, and I believe his dripper that he had on his mech mod.
On a hybrid mech
mod. On a hybrid mech mod, which means there's no connector pin in between that touches the battery. Like, that's legit his dripper touching the battery.
And that's how it works. Yeah. So when you hit the button touches the other end of the battery and you have a complete circuit.
Exactly. So what happened was the pin was too short. Hard shorted, which I don't know the definition of that. We're not going to get too far into that. But.
Yeah. A hard short is like a direct contact short. Like, yeah. A regulated mod could short out, and generally that's like when your board craps out. But a hard short is like a direct contact. Okay, like,
there you go. So, and in turn, with the overpower and the overheating of the battery and that hard short, pretty much just caused his, I'm assuming, I don't know if the mod blew up in his hand, because I think his hand was fine, but it caused his actual dripper to blow up in his mouth because of all that power being pushed through the coil and just too much power, not knowing what he was doing.
And like just to talk about amps, like, my math is putting it somewhere at 60 amps, 50 amps, 60 amps.
The battery's only, the one
18650. They're rated to 20 amps, but even then on continuous fire, they'll only put out about 17. Because running a battery at its full capacity is strenuous for the battery. So now, like, you are so far gone the safe threshold of that battery that it's not even funny. Like, you're asking for triple the output.
So moral of this story is, the news article that I read pretty much summed it up as, this guy was vaping, his vape exploded, vaping is bad. That's not the case.
We are here to tell you.
Yeah, this guy was vaping an unregulated mod, unsafely, not knowing what he was doing, which then caused it to blow up. Yes, that is the ending. It blew up in his mouth. But it's not vaping's fault. It's the fact that he didn't know what he was doing, and he did something which takes expertise. And he obviously wasn't an expert.
I mean, I know a lot about vaping. I don't trust mechs. Exactly. I don't like mechs. I don't think they should be available to anybody. Sorry, people that actually know what they're doing. I'm really sorry. But it's not like there's stores that are turning away $40 for their mechs. Because a sale's a fucking sale.
Yep.
Oh, I said the F word.
Oh, wow.
A sale is a sale, and that really sucks, especially like in the States where regulations, they can't explain mods, they can't talk about battery safety, they can't recommend anything. Like, it's a concoction for bad things to happen.
Yep.
So in combination, no vents on the vape,
yep.
No computer chip inside to tell the vape to turn off because you're about to blow.
Yep.
And lack of education.
Lack of education.
Because regulation stops education from
exactly.
happening. It's preventing him from being properly educated.
Exactly.
So there you go, people.
That's what
I'm
happened.
Sorry. The whole, like, I know, okay, I've been vaping for 2 years, over 2 years now, and I know a lot of people in the community. I have never once, I personally do not know anyone that has had a vape explode. Not once.
It's rarer than you think, but it gets blown up when it happens.
Nobody wanted to outlaw cell phones when the Note 7 started to go bang.
Burning houses down,
maiming and mutilating people. Yeah. Nobody said that cell phones are unsafe. The battery was faulty.
Yep.
It doesn't, like, and people say it like batteries, that can't happen with anything. You could have a AAA explode and that's going to be no fun.
Yeah.
Doesn't matter if it's this big or this big, like.
More of the story, buy something regulated.
Yep. Make sure there's a computer chip in it.
Yeah.
So we're going to just talk about some packaging, some labeling, these little dripper bottles. We've talked about the Maslow stuff before, so we're not going to really dive into it. It's, I like it. It's a nice, classy label. It's got a triangle, some cursive letters that say their name.
Nice little label.
Yeah.
Got all the names of their juices on little, like, wooden deck
panel
style
panel kind of things
behind it.
Yeah.
Yep.
It's got your Nick strength, your VG, your, this one says 19 plus. That's cool. 30 mils. One thing about not just, like, not against Maslow, but against these, like, glass dripper bottles is sometimes, there, just did it again. Sometimes these lids don't like to go on straight. They cross thread.
And I feel like once it happens once,
it's kind of dicked.
Yeah, it keeps happening.
Yeah. It's just something, it kind of gets worse, actually.
I don't think it
has something to do with the little childproof ring inside,
yeah.
I think. But I'm not sure.
But still, it's nothing against Maslow. It's just sometimes the glass bottles do that. I've had it happen to the other companies as well, so it just happens.
Yeah.
But yeah, your typical glass bottle.
It's got a little, glass, glass nip thing nip. Inside. It's got the nip-nip on top. The nip-nip.
Nip-nip.
Other than that. Yeah.
It's a typical glass bottle. Good stuff.
So, we're going to talk about some juice.
Some
we're gonna
flavor.
Talk about some flavors here. I'm vaping on Safety, which is a... thank you, sir.
You're welcome.
I'm vaping on Safety, which is a...
It's a lemon cake.
A lemon cake with vanilla icing. And I haven't had very many lemon vapes before, so this is kind of... This is new to me. And I really like it. It's like it's
I
a
thought
really,
it was really good.
It's a really mellow flavor. Mm-hmm. Like it's not like a punch in the teeth with flavor, but it's there.
It's definitely you get a good cake flavor, like a good I wouldn't say like pastry, but it doesn't taste like just straight up lemon and vanilla. It's definitely like a toned down lemony kind of flavor with a good mix of vanilla, I find. Wish I wouldn't try it out of yours. But this one actually they're all really, really good, so it's hard to pick a favorite, but I really like this one. Yep. That's it. Definitely full of flavor, though, I find.
It is.
Like, you're not getting a very... It's not a very undertony flavor where it's like, eh, is there a whole lot of flavor? No, like, you get a good amount of flavor, but it's not overkill. And I have Psychological, which is a grape and berry... And it kind of reminds me of Cap
From Versus.
From Versus,
yeah.
But it's definitely better, I find. It's the grape adds a good flavor. I find it has a bit of a grape soda mix. So it's like, have some grape drink and some mixing it with some
berries,
berry juice. Good stuff.
My only kind of thing with the Psychological is that the grape tastes really good. The grape is like a really organic flavor. And I find that the berry flavor tastes... artificial kind of
throws it off a bit,
yeah. Like it'd be like eating like a candy kind of berry flavor,
yeah.
But paired with
like
kinda like
a fruit roll-up,
yeah, but paired with like a good grape.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not saying it's bad, I just
definitely not.
They could have had a little bit more of an organic berry flavor, but at the same time they have a really strong grape flavor, which kind of rounds
yeah.
It all off.
Definitely.
I think if it was like that berry flavor on its own, it would be very throaty.
Yeah.
But the grape kind of tones it down just a little bit.
The berry, I think, adds a little bit of a sour zip to it, which is nice. Because instead of just a sweet, succulent grape, which you can really taste, you got a little bit of a pop of sour.
Kind of like, yeah.
Kind of like if you're eating blackberries with it.
Yeah. It's all like kind of bitter, kind of sour at the end. I like it.
I don't know. Out of the two, which one would you say is the best?
Out of these two, I think the lemon is the best.
That's what I was going to say. Lemon's definitely the best out of these two.
Now that we vaped them all, let's just talk about it. I personally would rank the five juices. It's a tie between the Esteem, which is the cola stuff, and Belonging, which is the mango strawberry. I think those two are tied for best in the lineup. And then after that, you'd have the lemon pound cake, and then you'd have the berry stuff, and what was the fifth one? Oh!
Self-actualization,
and I think that the vanilla custard with the blueberry,
that's what it was.
I think that one's not bad, but just in my opinion, the bottom of the ladder.
Seems funny. That's because you don't like the custard too, though, right? Mine's a little bit different, because I think it's a tie between the lemon pound cake and Esteem. For number one, Esteem's probably my favorite, so actually I'll rank Esteem number one, which was the cola candy. Lemon pound cake is going to be two. The grape and berries is going to be three. Wasn't a big fan of
no,
the mango and strawberry.
No, I really liked it.
I'll put that four.
And last,
put the custard. It was good, but it was all right.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're all really good juices, though. Like, definitely top of the scale juices. You know, if you're looking for premium, this stuff's a good lot.
I like how Maslow had, like, their flavor profile is spot on. And that's partly
yes.
Why I didn't like the custard, because I don't like custard.
Yep.
I don't enjoy custard at all. So a vape that tastes exactly like vanilla custard is just not appealing to me. somebody that likes custard or like probably that really likes the House of Custards. There's a whole line of juice that are just custards. If you like that, you should check out the self-actualization from Maslow.
Yeah, it's good stuff, that's sure. All great stuff. Good job, Maslow.
I like how every, like, the five juices that we got, they kind of appeal to, like, a different market of people exactly. really well. Like, if you want a candy vape, I could recommend a Steam. If want, like, a fruity vape, I'd recommend Belonging. If you want, if you wanted a, or that even, yeah. If you wanted, like, a fruit, it could be... the grape and berry or the Belonging, the mango strawberry. If you want like a good pastry vape that's just mellow that you could vape all day or right before bed or even like with your coffee or something, I'd give it to the Safety, the lemon pound cake. It just, I like how they appealed to everybody and did it really well. Usually, usually like when juices are at different ends of the spectrum like that,
You get one that's really good.
And... Yeah, you get one that's really good. And so, like, you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, sometimes companies try too hard to appeal to everybody.
Yeah.
And this is just, like, one of those times where it just worked out. Like, they have something that everybody could enjoy besides, like, a tobacco juice.
Yep.
Good job, Maslow. Really get it.
All right, outro take one.
They have Vegemite.
Three, two, one. Go.
So guys, once again, this has been another Beaver Fever Juice review. I'm Gage.
I'm Adam.
Everybody wish Adam a happy belated birthday.
And Gage, happy belated birthday.
Oh shit, yeah. Our birthdays are 6 days apart, yeah. So.
His was on the 11th, mine was on the 17th. Yeah, we're old.
We're 22.
Woo!
Feeling 22. That fucking song, man. You know how many people sent me that song, like, in my inbox?
I'm amazed, I didn't get any.
Oh, dude, was annoying. I got, like, four of them. But anyway, guys, Beaver Fever Juice Review, we were talking about the Maslow line. That wraps it up for these five amazing juices. Be sure to check out the previous two videos, because there we talked about...
Esteem in the first one.
We talked about Esteem, and then in the video after that, we talked about Belonging and self-actualization. And like we were saying earlier, man, these juices appeal to everyone.
Yep, anybody could like them.
I think so.
If you're into that, right? Like, so.
I mean, like, I don't mean that, like, everybody is going to love this vanilla pound cake, but I mean if you're into pastry vapes, this is worth checking out. If you're into candy vapes, you should check out
Esteem.
If you like kind of mango strawberry, you should check out Belonging. They have something in every spectrum, which is nice to see, because sometimes companies try to do that, and they end up with, like, a line of shit. Like...
Just a big line.
Line anyways, of turds, guys, man.
We're going to give a shout out to Simon, the guy who gave us this juice to review. Thank you very much, Simon Stokes.
Simon's the guy behind the Great North Vape Review and the Great North Vape Lounge. I owe Simon an apology. I've been promoting his juice company under the wrong name. Simon, I'm really freaking sorry, man. I've been saying the Blind Predator, and I just figured out the other day that it's actually the Wild Predator. So I'm really sorry, guys. Anybody that was looking for the Blind Predator, it's called the Wild Predator.
But be sure to check it out.
Be sure to check it out.
Simon has
some awesome juice, man. He's got that that lemon donut. He's got that watermelon cotton candy, and I'm pretty sure... I haven't talked to him in a little while, so I... Because last time I talked to him, everything was like... before he made like the finalized of it. What I tried was a vanilla Coke, I think. So I know for sure the first two are a lemon donut and a watermelon cotton candy. And those two are phenomenal. Those two are spot on.
Sounds good, that's true. I want to try a lemon donut.
They're good, man.
Actually, I want to try them both. Who doesn't like cotton candy?
I don't know. So thank you, Simon. Much appreciated, brother. Keep vaping. Vape on.
Remember, everybody, to like, comment, subscribe to the video, share it to all your friends, your family, your roommate, your ex-roommate, your ex-girlfriend, your girlfriend's ex-boyfriend.
If you guys know anybody that's kind of unsettled, maybe our fellow vapers have friends, families, significant others that are a little bit unsettled by these stories of vapes blowing up, check out the first 5 minutes of this video. We talked about that a little bit. And just once again to emphasize that when vapes blow up, it's not because all vapes are going to blow up. We're talking like 99% of the time human error.
Human unregulated mods.
A lack of education. Yeah. Unregulated mods. Inexperienced builders.
Just so much human error that it's hard to feel bad.
It honestly upsets me that people... It honestly upsets me that the image of vaping that is being painted by the media, especially to smokers, the number of smokers that say, I'm not going to vape because I don't want to blow up.
You're not going to blow up.
Just, you know what I mean? Like, I'm just going to...
Does it have a screen? Does it tell you what you're doing? Pretty much.
It sucks because, like, for the last 2 years, I've been promoting this as a healthier alternative, not harmless, but less harmful than smoking. And now I have, not only do I have people that know nothing about vaping, but I have smokers telling me that vaping is either worse for my health, I'm gonna blow myself up.
Yep.
Shit like that. It's just starting to...
I had a guy tell me that he knows a guy who knows a guy. That's the best part about it.
That's when you know it's true.
That had to get his lungs drained because there is liquid in his lungs. And I was like, I know a guy who's been vaping for how long has John been vaping? Like 5 years?
John's been vaping like 4 or 5 years.
Yeah, this guy's been vaping 5 years and he feels healthier than a horse. He smoked for what, 25? Probably more.
His whole adult life?
Yeah, his whole adult life, like, this guy smokes cigarettes. And he says he feels so much healthier now that he's vaping. Like, it's obvious a better alternative than smoking cigarettes.
I mean, I'm not like the best example, but I mean, I am an example. And here's how. I've been smoking for 5 years. And then I've been vaping for about 2. I know people, like, that's nothing compared to people that have smoked for 30, 40, 50 years of their life. But what I can tell you is that by the end of it, when I was still smoking cigarettes, roughly a pack and roughly a half pack to a pack a day, I got to a point where I couldn't run. I had to give up riding my longboard because riding more than a block, I was doubled over trying to breathe. It's winter now, so I don't really jog. But in the summer, I jog, and I've been vaping for 2 years. Find me a smoker that can jog about 3K and not be, like, doubled over dying.
I know that feeling.
When I quit smoking the first 6 months, my body started to expel the shit in my lungs. The amount of tar that came out of my body in those 6 months was absolutely fucking disgusting. Like, I'm not saying it's harmless. I'm saying it's less harmful. And now we have major news sources that are like, vapes can explode. We have people that are like, don't vape. I blew my face off. Tell us the whole damn story there, bud.
Yep, that's the big key there. Is the media is cutting out the important parts. To people who vape and people that want to vape, they're just saying, you vape, it blows up. You know, it sucks.
Yeah.
But really, they're cutting out the most important part of how did it blow up? Why did it blow up? Was it human error? Was it regulated? All the information that's needed to prove that vaping is bad is cut out every single time.
Like, you know what, man? Like, if regulated mods were exploding, I would not be sitting here going, vaping is safe. 99% of products on the market are safe. If you have just some basic battery safety, and honestly, basic battery, like, you don't need to be an expert on Ohm's law. You don't need if you're running a regulated device, all you really need to know is, like, the general ins and outs of batteries. Like, oh, when should I get new batteries? How is it safe to charge batteries? When should I rewrap my batteries? Like, you don't, I'm not saying to vape you need to be an expert on all of it. I'm just saying you need to kind, you should know a little bit.
Yeah. Even me, I haven't bought new batteries or switched my wraps forever just because they're perfectly fine.
And you have the luxury of just leaving your batteries in your device. Yeah. Like, they don't go in and out, in and out. Like, I myself, when I was switching batteries from mods and stuff, it was tearing the wrappers.
Yeah.
I had to rewrap them. Because when that wrapper tears, the battery becomes a negative terminal.
End of story, pretty much.
Anyway, guys, we are the Beaver Fever Juice Review. We'll be back next week with another new juice. Until then, have a good day, and remember to always keep her cloudy.
Hey guys, can I move over?
I'm coming in.
What are we doing?
Well, I'm just gonna kinda do a thing here as well. Hey guys, it's Jordan from Screaming Alien Productions. I help make the videos for these guys. I do the editing and posting and stuff like that. I've got a new series coming out on Screaming Alien Gaming. It's called Minecraft Explorer. It's hosted by Alien Waldo. He's part of our team, and he's our gaming expert, so he's going to be taking care of that. So you guys can check that out at Screaming Alien Gaming. There is a link down below in the description, and I hope you guys enjoy the videos. Have a good one.
Yeah. Thanks, guys. Have a good one.